West Metro Fire started a drone program, otherwise known as a UAV program, unmanned aerial vehicles.
Using technology to keep the fire district and firefighters safe. In just a few short months, West Metro's drone program has provided a helping hand for crews with an eye-in-the-sky perspective on several large incidents.
The drone can be up in the air in a matter of minutes and provide real-time video and data back to that incident commander. And the fact that it's real-time, it's maneuverable, so we can change angles, change directions, change altitude.
When firefighters respond to a call, the initial information they have comes from the person who dialed 911. Once crews arrive on scene, they do a size up and then determine strategy. A drone can help the crews not only see real time what's happening right now, but it can also give them an idea of what may happen.
Wildfire is a huge one, both for being able to get what we call a size up. So getting above a fire and seeing just how big it is, how quickly it's moving, and what it might be moving to. And then also giving that incident commander an eye on the crews on the ground for safety, to enhance that safety for our folks.
That real-time intel can also help determine whether or not firefighters need to go in, or in this case, up. This fire was sparked by strong winds that pushed a large branch into a power line on the roof of a restaurant on Colfax.
From the ground, you could see smoke and flames up on the roof of the building. When we put the drone up and were able to visualize it, particularly with our infrared, we could see that there were a couple pieces of the tree that were burning, but the roof of the building itself was not. And because of that, we didn't have to put any firefighters at risk to go up there and extinguish it. We were able to wait for XL Energy and not put anyone in peril.
On hazmat incidents, the drone can be used to do some reconnaissance of the scene before firefighters are put into danger. That may be looking at the tanker that rolled over or identifying a placard on the side of a vehicle that's leaking. All this can be done from a great distance away and without a firefighter even having to put on a hazmat suit.
Down slowly.
And once firefighters go in, a drone can help get them out. On this rescue in Clear Creek Canyon, a drone showed crews the fastest way to get an injured hiker to an ambulance.
We had a hiker that was off trail at a high altitude above the creek and really in an inaccessible area by vehicles. We were very quickly able to fly over the ridge line and get to where this downed hiker was. And then we did a few things for the incident commander. One was just that set of eyes again so that they could actually see from a half mile away what was really going on the other side of the ridge. We were able to help identify a route for a high angle rappel down to the creek bed and then a route along the creek bed to get them back to safety.
The drone eliminated the need for firefighters to hike through difficult terrain and scouted ahead to find the most easy way out.
West Metro now has two drones and four trained pilots who are always on call for incidents where technology could be the difference that makes for a good outcome.
It's a great benefit to our citizens in a few different ways. One, it's very cost effective. And ultimately, you know, what our citizens have told us the most is they want help quickly, and they want help effectively. This tool gets us there faster, gets the right resources to the right place, and does so, you know, at a fraction of the cost of other potential technologies. You know, the other important thing about it is that it enhances the safety for our firefighters, which allows them to get home to their families at night as well.
One more.
One more.
Yeah, maybe.